This is a letter. A letter to the graduating class of 2014.
This is a poem. A poem to the world, to the generations who have preceded us, to the generations to come.
This is a speech for all those who have raised us, who have assisted us, who have challenged us, to those who have given us the opportunity to be here today.
Thank you. Thank you, parents, for waking up at all hours of the night to turn the Wi-Fi back on so we could finish our homework.
Thank you, teachers, for rounding up that last 0.5% so I could have that GPA-boosting B- instead of that catastrophic C+.
Thank you, friends, for showing up at 2 a.m. to jump my hoopty of a car after an all-night cram session for finals.
And thank you to all the people who've taught us that regardless of how frustrating our lives are, that we will be able to carry on.
Grab life by the horns and hang on tight? For each and every one of us, the answer should probably be a resounding no. We look back with regret. We never seize the moment. We never perform to the fullest of our abilities. Our insecurities, our doubts, and our fears, all of these at one point or another, have stopped us, have blocked us, have made fools of us as we gave excuses instead of taking responsibility. Yet, despite all of these shortcomings, we can see that day by day, we have gotten better and better.
We have learned that instead of saying, "I'm so bad at math," we take responsibility and study for that final. Instead of saying, "I'm just a messy person," We hold ourselves accountable, adjust for our weaknesses, and clean up our act and our binders. We have grown up, and we have learned how to behave like a grown-up. And maybe it wasn't something we were graded on in class, but growing up was a part of school just as much as 11 sentence paragraphs or FRQs. You see, the things that have shaped us as a class, that have given us unity through adversity and unity through diversity, these are the things that set us up for life. Because the real world is full of challenges.
School is not just here to teach us facts, to burn into our brain that A squared plus B squared equals C squared. School is here to convey to us harsher truths, like disappointment, failure, doubt, and disagreement. And the people who've experienced those truths of life and grown from them, those are the people who are our innovators. These are the ones who look back with no regrets, who see the opportunities in front of them and choose to work hard for them. These are the ones who see the laws of physics and the boundaries of imagination as nothing more than guidelines. These people are our future. Today, we choose to join them because every moment up to this instant, everything we have experienced so far, this has been our prologue, our exposition. Do you see the future stretched out before you? Take it and run with it, because the rest of your life, the rest of your story, is still unwritten.
Something in the distance, so close you can almost
our goals, to persevere to achieve our successes, to build from our failures. We understand what it means to be a human being, that when you see someone struggling, it's okay to lift them up, and it is never okay to tear them down. It's okay to be different, to stand out in a crowd, and to stand up for what you believe in.
And it's awesome when, even if you don't agree with someone's beliefs, you support their right to believe those things. Because here at Cosumnes Oaks, we put the CO into COHSIST.
We understand that it's okay to be part of marching band, as well as the football team.
It's okay to be a member of Gay Straight Alliance.
And it's okay to be a member of Muslim Club.
And Anti-Bullying Club.
And Art Club.
And Christian Club, too.
We understand that it's okay to be in theater.
To be in leadership.
To be in honors and AP classes.
To be in sports.
Or to be in none of these. Because people are so much more than the titles or badges they have.
At CO, we have learned to believe in each other. To support each other. We have grown up together, and we have changed in the best kind of ways. Because of this, we will go far.
The world will see us as it wants to see us. As a test score.
A list of achievements on a computer screen.
An admission.
An ethnicity.
A gender.
A statistic.
In the simplest of terms. In the most convenient definitions. But what we have found out is that each one of us is a nerd.
And an athlete.
A leadership fanatic. A drama queen.
And a goody two-shoes. But when it comes down to it, who are we?
We are the products of each of our unique experiences. We are the individual characteristics that celebrate our difference and set us apart as lone wolves. We are the shared goals and dreams that tie us together.
We are 455 faces, pale and trembling. But this time, we are also prepared scholars, accomplished communicators, continuing learners, and knowledgeable global citizens. Some of us are excited, some of us are nervous, but all of us have found our way.
All of us have been failures at one point or another, but instead of being stuck in that failure, we have risen like a phoenix from the ashes with the strength to carry on. Now we stand here at the beginning of our true story, ready to continue our unwritten destiny.
We are the Wolf Pack. The Wolf Pack that time nor trial may divide. What began 6 years ago as habit has transformed into tradition. Remember the lessons learned here. Remember those who taught them to you. And remember those who learned them with you. Above all, remember that
the strength of the pack is the wolf, and the strength of the wolf is the pack.